In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Today marks the first Sunday of the blessed month of Baba. And this month, the Church has chosen for us certain readings that show the power of God and His goodness towards us, and how He heals, and how He solves problems, and how He touches bodies that were sick, and such bodies are healed. And the reading that was read for us today from the Gospel of St. Mark chapter 2 is one of such healings, the healing of the paralytic. As the Lord started His ministry in a city that's called Capernaum, people started to get attracted to Him, and they started to follow Him. So when He entered into a house, the crowd followed Him. And the scene was so crowded to the extent that there was no space for no one to stand, even at the door that was really busy. And knowing of His abilities to heal, five friends thought to bring one of them who was paralytic for the Lord Jesus Christ to touch him. And as they didn't have no mean but to go over the roof, they went up the roof, and they uncovered the roof, and they had to lay down the bed of the paralytic that he might become right before the Lord Jesus Christ, and he might receive the healing that they expected him to have. In fact, such miracle, as much as it's a great miracle, it's also a lot of lessons for us to learn on how does the healing happen. Like what they had in mind, the four friends, and even the sick person himself, they had in mind that, well, they want the Lord Jesus Christ to touch him, and then he did start to stand up, pick up his bed, and go to his house. Yet there were more details to know about the miracle, more than just the healing of the body. And what they learned on that day, there are things that are more important than the healing of the body. And such things that we need to learn today are these things that happened in this miracle before the healing of the body. If you notice, the Lord has entered this house and He started to preach the word of God to them. Before seeking a quick solution for your problem, you may need to notice this. You may need to learn this. There are things that come first. You need to get introduced to the Word of God. You may need to come stay at His feet and tell Him, Lord, please teach me what is Your will in my life. Do You really want me to be healed? Do you really want this problem and the bank to be solved? Do you really want my work problem to be solved? Or what do You really want in my life, Lord? I need to hear Your voice. I need to be in direct contact with You. I need to listen to Your words in the Bible. The Lord first started with preaching the word in this house before even this paralytic and his friends came to the house. And that's something for you and for me to learn, that the Lord wants to heal, yes, but there are things that we need to not first before healing, and such things they start with the Word of God. I need to start reading the Word of God. I need to start studying it, because this will help me discover my weaknesses, will help me discover my sins, and such sins might be the actual reason of the problem, not the financial problem that I have or the marital problem that I have. It's a sin that is in there that I don't want to give up. Such sin I'm going to be able to discover if I have a good relationship to the Word of God. If I stay before Him in prayer time, I'll be able to find out, well, there are so many weaknesses that I need to fix. Maybe the Lord is just grabbing my attention to this, that I need to fix things in my life that needs to be fixed for a long time now. The first thing that happened in this miracle is the Lord was preaching the word to those who gathered in this house. And what did the Lord said before doing the miracle? And the Bible says here that when He saw their faith, The miracle wasn't to happen at all if they didn't have such great faith that made them just to climb up the roof and to uncover the roof and then make a hole and then put lay down this paralytic in it. That's a great faith that was turned into actions in their life. And the Lord is telling me and telling you today, if you're concerned too much about a certain problem, you may need to start with this. You may need to start with trusting in Him. He's able, He's mighty. He can do it for you. He's able. He has the power and He has the tool to do it. And he has enough wisdom to do it the right way. Plus, He loves you and He cares for you as a good father of yours. I need and you need to trust in His power. I need and you need to trust in His love to you and to me. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. That's what the four friends and the paralytic has done. When he saw their faith, and this was the start of his touch of healing, when he saw their faith, he said, well, I'm gonna take an action with this person. When you have faith and when you trust in the Lord, when you have faith in the Lord, when you submit to Him, when you put the problem at His feet, when you handle it to Him, what will happen is He's going to either solve your problem or He's going to help you to be able to overcome the problem. The problem might stay, but you're going to be having peace while having the problem. I've seen so many people with diseases that are like terminating diseases, cancers and similar diseases. And such people, they'd come to the Lord seeking help and seeking healing, and they keep praying and trusting in His power. And what happened then? Sometimes they get healed. But in other cases, which are many cases, they get healed inside in a way that they'll be able to accept what they have as a crown that the Lord has given them and they're in heaven and eternal life. So trusting Him will solve the problem either way. When the Lord saw their faith, He started to intervene and He started to talk to the paralytic. And the first thing the Lord has said to this paralytic, He told them, your sins are forgiven you. He looked at him and He told them, your sins are forgiven you. And this was something that was not expected by anyone there, neither the paralytic nor anyone else around him. Instead of having to focus on my problem, I might need to focus on something that is more important that the Lord has focused on first, which is cleaning up my heart. I need to repent, my son. I need to seek forgiveness first before I seek healing. I need to seek forgiveness before I seek solving of my problem. I need to come to Him, examine myself, confess my sins, and seek forgiveness, because this has to happen first before the healing happens, before solving the problem happens. I need to heal such soul first before I heal the body. And if you notice, when Abuna goes to pray the litany of the sick for someone who is sick, the content of this litany, the content of this prayer is mainly focused on the healing of the soul. It does not focus, unless in a very small part of it, we focus only on the healing of the soul. We focus on the repentance of the person and the peace that would come to his heart. We don't ask the Lord for healing the body except for one sentence at the end, and that's it. Because there are things that has to come first before healing the body, which is healing the soul. Healing your body is just something temporary. Even if you're going to get healed today, you might be sick in 10 years from now, or 20 years, or 50 years. And at the end, this body is going to die at the end anyways. But healing the soul will give you eternal life. And that's what the Lord was concerned about in this scene. He said to the paralytic, son, your sins are forgiven you. So first the Lord has started with preaching His word to them. And the Lord looked at their faith, and he asked the he granted forgiveness to this man first before he's done the healing to him. And at the end, which was the fourth step in this miracle, the Lord has told this man, arise, pick up your bed, and just go home. And this tells you and tells me that the Lord cares also for our earthly cares. He cares for what's going to happen tomorrow in your first hour of your shift. He cares about what is really annoying you in regards to this schoolmate whom you're really bothered of. He cares about the tiny things that you care about. He cares about our needs. Although he cares first about our earthly, future, he cares about our eternal future first, yet he cares also about our earthly issues and our earthly needs. He's able to heal, he's able to solve, he's able to intervene, but he's asking you and asking me to seek first his kingdom, and all the things will be granted to you. All these things are going to be given to you. Bring your worries to him, your financial problems, your sicknesses, problem that has no solution, bring it to him, because he's able to solve it. Although he cares more about the healing of the soul, yet your body also is in his care. The miracle of healing the paralytic is telling you and telling me that there are things that are more important for us than the problem that we're really concerned about. What is more important is to listen to his word. What is more important is to seek forgiveness and to trust in his power. May his name be glorified in the church forever and ever. Amen.